everyone, and welcome to Vlogmas Day 19. Today I'm going to be doing a festive makeup routine that I like to wear. So let's go on with the video. Now, some people might find this a bit strange, but I always like to do my eye makeup first, because especially with the eyeshadow I'm going to be using, it's very, like, it's red, so it's very hard to wipe off the excess that's on your face because it does fall down quite a bit. So I always do my eye makeup first. So I'm going to be using the e.l.f. Little Compact eyeshadow, and this is a red and a black. But first I'm going to be applying the Urban Decay eye primer onto my eyelids. I've nearly run out, so there's not going to be that much in there. So you just put a bit on, tap it in your eyes. And then I use this brush. Blending. So I'm going to start off with the red, and I'm going to use this brush. So again, just put it on your eyelid. Like, as you can see, it's already fallen down. I do have a tool for that, actually. It's quite hard to hold the mirror and use it, so you just put it under your eye and then it catches all the excess. Okay, it doesn't look good when it's like this, but when the whole face is done, it looks good. Well, I think so anyway. So I'm also gonna use the black side of this, get a little bit, and then blend it on the side of my eyes, you'll see. Now, I do notice that the black eyeshadow doesn't come out very well on the e.l.f. palette, so I'm going to use the Naked palette and use Creep right there. So as you can see, it comes out much better. Make sure you get it even, then you have to blend it. Obviously with the red. Right, so now I've finished eyeshadow, I'm going to use the Scandalite 24 Hour Wear by Rimmel. I also get this brush, this angled brush, and get a little bit on, and always do it underneath my eyes. Right, that's my eyes done for now. So now I'm going to do the rest of my face. So I'm using Rimmel Wake Me Up in Classic Beige. Now, I don't know if this is the right brush for concealer, but this is the brush I like to use for concealer. Over my skin because it's quite blotchy. Now, I always use one of these to put my foundation on, and I'm using the Dream Satin Liquid by Maybelline in Light Porcelain, that's what it's called. I'll just spread it all over. If you wonder why I'm looking here, it's because I've got a mirror here. Then I'm going to use one of my Christmas sponges to blend it in. I very rarely use makeup brushes to put my foundation on. Sometimes I do like around the eyes because it's better, but not all over. So if you know any good foundations for quite oily skin, then let me know. I can never seem to find a foundation that stays on properly, even if I use setting spray. Now I'm going to use the brush around my eyes, like I said. Anybody else find that when they put foundation on their nose, it looks like not as good as the rest of your face? It always comes off my nose first. Now I'm going to set my foundation with the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder, and I like to use this again because I think it sets it, because otherwise it makes your skin look oily, not oily but shiny. I have quite red skin as well, so I need to make sure it's all covered up. So now that's done, I'm going to use the I'm going to use the MAC bronzing powder in Golden. I use my powder again to go over it because it's quite dark. Now you can't really tell in the camera, but you can tell it's still on, like in person. And I'm going to use the MAC blusher in D. Dame. Now I only put a tiny bit of blusher on. So tiny, you can barely notice I've put it on. And then, same thing again. Powder over the top. The Urban Decay Naked Illuminated. It's very sparkly. And I also use their brush. But if you don't use these brushes are also good for contouring. But I get this brush, and instead of just going like on here, I go all over with this one. Because it doesn't, it's more golden, and I like a sort of silvery highlight. And you can't really tell you've got much on, I just think it makes the bronzer look more golden. I then use the Urban Decay Afterglow 8-Hour Powder Highlighter in Sin. I also use this little palette I got. I'm not too sure where it's from, I've had it for quite a while, but I only ever use the highlighter from it because it is a really good highlighter. I think highlighter is one of my favourite pieces of makeup. No, it's really good. And it's, I think this palette was literally about £3. Crazy. I'm now going to do my eyebrow, so I just use this eyebrow pencil. And fill them in. A funny fact, until about, March this year, I never filled my eyebrows in. No, they look a bit better, but I also use this Trade Secrets Brow Perfector Kit. I usually use this one here. Just get some on your brush. It's like a liquid. It doesn't look it, I thought it's powder, but it is a liquid. And then do the same, but you can shape them. Then I use a little brush on the end to go over them. As you can see. And then I also get a little Techniques brush and just put a little bit of highlighter underneath my eyebrows. Not much, you like hardly at all that. I then use three mascaras. Well, actually, first I'm going to use my Urban Decay setting spray. So you're supposed to do it in a cross, an X, and then a T, but I just do it all over. Lastly,
I also use
this, which is like a this colour eyeliner, and I put it on my waterline. So if you can see. To make the eye stand out more. Then for lipstick, I always use a lip balm first to moisturise your lips. I then use the Urban Decay lip liner. I'm going to use Max Velvet Teddy mixed with Cream Sheen Darling, which is the Mariah Carey one. So I put this on first. Then I'm using Velvet Teddy here. And there we go. I use quite a light lip because I've got dark eyes. And you shouldn't really mix dark eyeshadow with dark lips. I've learned. But I hope you enjoyed this video and you liked the festive makeup routine.